Hey guys, Ivan here, and this video we are starting with a Sergio Oliva Jr. update. So lately he has been posting a lot of stuff, a lot of videos of himself flexing in a sleeveless t-shirt, in a tank top and stuff like that, but it's been a while since he posted a physique update, a proper physique update, and here you can see exactly what is going on. And when I saw this, I was like, wow, alright, this looks amazing. So in all those photos and videos that he was posting, he did look really good. He looked really thick, really big, really full and round, and also he was getting leaner. But this one tells us a few things. This one tells us that Sergio Oliva really means business. So he really acted lately like he was super confident that he really is planning on making a significant impact on this Arnold Classic, and this is gonna be his best ever. By far. It seemed like that. His mindset seemed like that, his mentality. And very rarely do bodybuilders act so confident when they don't look good. When they look amazing, when they look improved, when they look like they can win a show, their confidence level changes. You can see it in their behavior. I mean, on social media, of course, and YouTube interviews they do and stuff like that. And Sergio really seemed super confident. And this is the story that somebody shared. And they say, what's crazy is even this picture doesn't show how truly massive Sergio Oliva is. I work out at the same gym he does, 100% the largest human I've ever seen in my life. Arms the size of my legs. And this is something I heard from many other people. They say that Sergio is actually big in person because he's taller. He's like 6 foot, 5 foot 9, 6 foot, something like that. And last year at the Arnold's, he was 285. And I asked him a question. I asked him, is he gonna be bigger, heavier this year at the Arnold's? He says, yes, he will. So imagine how big he's gonna be on that stage compared to some shorter bodybuilders like Nick Walker, like William Bonek. So Sergio is one of those deceivingly big bodybuilders. You need to stand next to him to see how big he is in person. Because as they say, short bodybuilders look good on photos, and tall bodybuilders look good in real life, in person. Me, I never saw Sergio in person, but I know people who have seen him, who have seen other bodybuilders in person, and they say that Sergio is one of the biggest bodybuilders that we have today. They also mention some other guys like Steve Kuklo, like Regan Grimes. So the point is, even though this photo looks amazing right here, it doesn't do him justice. In a Fuad Abiad's podcast, Fuad actually had Sergio in the top 3 at the Arnold's, and they are not in good terms. They had a serious fight, you know, you guys remember, they had a serious argument, they went back and forth, they don't like each other personally, and I'm sure Fuad doesn't like Sergio, but he respects his physique and he actually has him in his top 3, he wasn't biased about it, he said it honestly, and I think he has a point. So, last year at the Arnold Classic, Sergio Oliva was beaten by Big Ramy, who is not doing the Arnold this year, Dexter Jackson, also not doing it, William Bonek, and Steve Kuklo. Now, Steve Kuklo did improve, I think, and I think he's gonna come super shredded, and Steve actually has a good chance of winning this show. Bonek was on a down path last year and the years before, but he had an injury and it seems like he recovered from it. So, Sergio, if he can, look at his back double bicep, wow, it looks really good, the glutes and the back and everything, he looks amazing, he was 5th last year. Now we have a lot of newcomers who might challenge Sergio, like Nick Walker, like Ian Valliere and the others, but, guys, he was 5th last year, 2 of the bodybuilders that beat him are not competing this year, and I get the impression that Sergio improved more than Steve Kuklo did. But Steve Kuklo also looks amazing, he looks improved, William Bonek too. So in order for Sergio to win the Arnold Classic, he needs to absolutely nail it. And if he does, I can see him win this Arnold Classic, I can, sure. And also, posing is really, really important at the Arnold Classic. And Sergio is one of the best posers in open bodybuilding today. Last year he won an award for the best poser on that night, and he might win it again. Because he really knows how to pose, he knows how to present his physique, he has the moves, he's a good entertainer as well, and also he has a history. His father competed against Arnold, so imagine Sergio Oliva's son, Sergio Oliva Jr., now winning Arnold's show, the Arnold Classic. That will make a hell of a story, and I don't know if the judges would take that into consideration. I think the man with the best physique and overall the best presentation will win, but it's something to be considered. So the question is, can Sergio take that victory? I think he can. I think it's very possible. Whatever you guys think though, tell me in the comment section down below. Can Sergio Oliva win the Arnold Classic in 2021? If you talk about the posing, I feel like the posing is way more emphasized in classic physique. Probably not emphasized enough, but more emphasized than in open bodybuilding. Right here, you can see an amazing poser and the winner in classic physique, the champion, Chris Bumstead, doing his twisted back shot. And this one just looks amazing. I mean, the amount of muscle that he's packing on, and it looks like he gained some more tissue to the back. Take a look at this. Just pay attention to the traps and the lats and also the arms. So it seems like he gained some tissue there again. Again, in the offseason, he gained muscle. When will this stop? I mean, we feel like there is a weight cap and these guys can't get any bigger, but Chris gets bigger every year. As far as the conditioning, at 5 weeks out, he looks amazing, 5.5 weeks out, so he has plenty of time to get peeled, probably more than he really needs. So he'll be in super condition at the Mr. Olympia stage, and as far as the muscularity, again, it seems like he gained more tissue. I mean, when I just saw this one photo, I thought, wow, it looks amazing. It doesn't look maybe as amazing as the previous photo that he posted, the one in black and white, but it looks good. The first thing that I pay attention to is probably how conditioned he is, the glutes. I took a look at the glutes. I saw that they are not quite there yet, but at 5 weeks, 5.5 weeks out, they are just where they need to be, just perfect, perfect spot to be in. And then I pay attention to overall muscularity. Now, I wasn't sure how much did he make progress. I mean, you can't just look at a photo, one photo, and tell. But if you compare it to his previous year's photo, then you can get the idea. And it looks like he gained some more tissue in traps, lower and upper traps, and it looks like he gained some muscle in the lats as well. Maybe shoulders and arms too. Now, of course, it's not the same lighting, he's a little bit more watery, a little bit more bulky here, so he may appear bigger, but I think when he gets super lean, he's gonna look even bigger, even more impressive. That's the thing with Chris, I talked about this before, he cannot push the gear too hard until it is time for it. He can't do it in the off-season. If he did, he would go to the Open, probably. So he can't really do that, but as the show is approaching, the gear starts kicking in and he looks better and better and more impressive. So if he looks like this right now at 5.5 weeks out, just imagine how he's gonna look at the Mr. Olympia stage. And this is not a discussion if he's gonna win the Mr. Olympia or not. This is just a discussion of how good his package is gonna be. What kind of masterpiece are we gonna witness at the Mr. Olympia 2021 in classic physique? If anybody can challenge him in classicness, then that's gonna be Logan Franklin, who immediately took the opportunity to do just that. And again, if you talk about the classic lines, then the only guy that has similar or classic lines on that level, in my opinion, is Logan Franklin. Of course, Logan still has a lot of work to do as far as muscle conditioning, as far as muscle maturity, details, density, and stuff like that. But as far as the lines, this guy is really freaking blessed. However, placing-wise, the Mr. Olympia, he can't probably get better than top 6, because classic physique is not about the classic lines only, it's not a golden era physique, it is classic physique, so details, conditioning, stuff like that, muscle maturity play a really big role, and Logan still has a lot of work to do, but if you talk about the classic lines, once again, this is basically as classic as it can get, really. And even though his legs seem small in that back twisted shot, they are not small. He has big legs. He's just posing that way because he wants to resemble Arnold. You know, Arnold had dominant upper body and smaller legs, and that used to be the standard in classic golden era type of physiques. So he also took a nickname. His nickname on Instagram now is the Texas Oak. And you guys know that Arnold's nickname was the Oak, and Logan is from Texas, so he's kind of Arnold from Texas, and he really does resemble Arnold in many poses. So if you take a look at this comparison, you will see that as far as the back and the arms and the delts, they are pretty close. Yes, Chris is bigger, but they're pretty close. It's very, very close. As far as the legs, I think it's only the posing that is hurting Logan. I think if he posed a little bit differently, he could emphasize the size, the massiveness of his legs, and he would look much better in this pose. Yeah, this is kind of making a better V-taper. It's actually maybe reminds me more of a Y letter, not so much V, because his legs look super tiny if he poses like this. But he has big legs, he doesn't have small legs, and he should pose like Chris right here. If he changed that, this pose would look really amazing. And that is Logan's favorite classic pose, so he looks really good in that one. And he took the opportunity, because Chris posted his version of it, and Logan thought, well, this is my favorite classic physique pose, so I will do this one as well, and I will do it probably better than Chris. And as far as the upper body, they are very close, but lower body, the way they're posing, Chris does it much, much better. And again, this is not a comparison as far as Mr. Olympia competition. No, Logan, I don't know, he didn't even qualify, I think. I don't know if he can get to the Mr. Olympia stage, but if he gets there, he can't beat guys like Terence Ruff and Breon Ainsley, Robert Timms and the others. He can be like top 6 best case scenario, because classic physique is not just the golden era type of physiques, there is a lot more into it. But if you talk about the classic lines, he is probably the only bodybuilder that can really challenge Chris. Mr. Olympia is approaching, it is October 7th to 10th, and as you can see right here in this poster, somebody probably got drunk when they made this poster, because if you pay attention, it says, it doesn't say Mr. Olympia October 7th to 10th, it says Mr. Olympmia. And also, they somehow managed to mess up the tag, as I highlighted it there. They tried to tag their own account and they wrote Mr. Olympia. So I don't know who's the admin of this page and who made this poster, but whoever did it is probably like drunk or on too much clan and their hands are shaking or something. I don't know what is going on, but I thought this was pretty hilarious. Olympia and Olympia. God, two mistakes in one post. What is this? And it's been like 2 hours since they posted it and it's still not changed or deleted or anything like that. So I'm guessing somebody is getting fired today. Alright, next we have Nathan D'Ascia, who is qualified for the Mr. Olympia. He qualified by winning the Europa Pro, the Spain Pro, beating Rolly Winkler. And this is him right now. He is also doing Arnold Classic UK. So, right now, I mean, he just competed, so he is shredded. And the thing is, with Nathan, he can get peeled so easily. What he needs to pay attention to is keeping the fullness. So right now, I'm assuming he is eating a lot. He's probably gonna eat a lot until like a week before the Arnold Classic UK. He will not probably diet too hard, and then he'll just drop the hammer and get peeled again. And I'm sure he'll maintain a really low body fat percent, because this guy, like, he can get peeled again. But the thing is, he looks so much better when he's fuller and also pretty conditioned. He can go with crazy crispness, and he can do that easily. He doesn't really have to suffer too much. But that's not the game that he needs to play. No, he needs to go with the fullness, and he can play that game really well. He just did against Rolly, and he annihilated Rolly. So can he win the Arnold Classic UK? I think he is the favorite to do that. Who can challenge him? How about Samson Dauda? He's coached by Miloš Šarčev now. And Miloš is known for getting these bodybuilders super peeled. There is like 4 weeks until Arnold Classic UK, so he can probably do a lot in 4 weeks. I'm sure this guy will get ripped. This guy is a little bit taller and he is super massive. He does have a really aesthetic shape, really complete physique, really nice big and full muscle bellies. Crazy from the back, crazy from the front, from the sides, very, very complete. It's really hard to pinpoint his weaknesses aside from conditioning. I think if he doesn't bring the conditioning, he will lose against Nathan. So Miloš needs to get him peeled, shredded. And if this guy is shredded, he can challenge anybody. He can be a top threat. He can win the Arnold Classic. He can maybe beat Nathan D'Ascia. Most likely not. I would still bet on Nathan. But I think this guy is going to give him a hell of a competition. Anyways, guys, that's going to do it for this video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. If you want to see more content like this, bodybuilding content, subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. All the best and bye-bye.